What up, guys? Episode 15, here we are. We have made it. We have a difficult game coming up at Highbury against Arsenal, who I think are currently sitting in like second or third in the table. They were top of the table until very recently. So let's proceed. And I mean, normally we're good away from home, but this is at Arsenal, so a win is unlikely. I mean, this was sort of peak Arsenal time back in 2001. So we're going to see lots of familiar names. I mean, the odds of Thierry Henry scoring are pretty short odds, I'd imagine. So we could get absolutely see Henry's already scored. So that's going to plan. Following the script, I did say Thierry Henry. And when you're playing central defenders, none of which are really in a really great form, then I guess that was kind of inevitable. Anyway, maybe that's the worst that's going to happen. We get that out the way, and perhaps we'll get a foothold on this game, or not, because Arsenal are still knocking it about. We've not even had a shot, I don't think. That's okay. He didn't even get a yellow card. First time I've seen Barnby's name in the commentary, and we're almost at half time. Because we've got David Seaman, so he's not had a good return. Oh yes, first attack. First attack, and we managed to score a goal. So we've been outplayed for almost 40 minutes. But I mean, if the scoreline stays like this when 90 minutes is over, then I'll be very happy. We're actually in a good patch here, so we don't really want the half-time whistle necessarily. Although Arsenal are still playing some good stuff. Pippier shouldn't be allowing Thierry Henry to head the ball like that. I think we will make at least one change at half time because we've been lucky to be going in level. Yellow card, ref. No? Don't know who this Aguinaldo guy is. Can you blow the whistle for half time? Thank you. Right, well, we've tried something pretty major. We've actually taken Hippier and Doncho off because they were both on fives. And my thinking is whoever we bring on can't do worse than 5 out of 10, surely. We've made Gerrard the captain. We've actually put Bishkan into central defence because apparently he can play there. We've put Haman in defensive midfield. Oh, well, that worked, didn't it? See, we didn't want the half-time whistle. We were actually playing well until half-time. We've only got one substitution left to make, so we will make that imminently before we fall 3-1 down. Or maybe not, because it didn't let me make the substitution. I thought I clicked the button on time. So that's a joke. I should have been able to make the substitution. Oh, thank you. I'm Mr. Dunn, that's my name. Right, Patrick, I'm giving you another chance to do something. You've got just under half an hour to help us rescue a point. Yeah, we are under pressure. Perhaps that was a big save. I don't know. I think Arsenal are looking more likely to extend their lead rather than us getting an equaliser. We had one. Well done, Bishkan. We had one purple patch just before half time, but other than that, it's been slim pickings. Come on. Oh, so close. That's a pretty solid substitution from Arsenal, isn't it, to bring Martin Keown on? I'll be proud of the lads if they get a draw out of this. Oh, Frode Kipper. Oh, Bishkan. Thought you're going to be a hero again, but you handballed it instead. They're creating chances way too easily. I mean, admittedly, we have got Marcus Babbel, Igor Bishkan, and Frode Kipper in defence, so. We've still got a bit of a chance. As long as it stays 2-1, we've got a chance right until the end. That's a yellow card. Okay, well, he's only got 12 minutes to stay on the pitch. Uh-oh. Made Marcus Babbel look like a piece of cheese there. So easily offside, Michael Owen. Well, we haven't played well. I mean, I think we deserve to lose this game. Haman's not been effective since he came on. Oh my goodness, David Seaman. Seaman's been a hero in this game. Arsenal should have won this comfortably. The fact we've still got a chance to equalise, this should be a real point snatch, but don't think it's going to happen. Didn't even bother to tell us about Schmitz's free kick. Well, I was kind of expecting to lose that. I was hoping for a draw, but we couldn't quite manage it. Let's see what the next game brings us. Well, this should be an easier game. We're in the League Cup. I think it's the third or the fourth round. I'm not sure. We're at Chesterfield. Slightly different proposition to having to play at Highbury. And we've got a debut. To look forward to. Park Jin Sub. I've signed him from South Korea for 300,000 smackers, and we are going to give him the prestigious number 5 shirt. Never mind about that. And let's get going. See how Park Jin Sub does. We're giving some fringe players a chance, as you'd expect in this kind of match. Fowler's playing. Solund is playing up front with Fowler, so we've given Heskey and Owen a rest. There he is. There's the debut boy himself. Yeah, I've made a few changes. Murphy's in the team. Dudek's in goal. Instead of Seaman. I mean, David Seaman had a great performance at Arsenal, even though he still conceded 2 goals. This would be embarrassing if we lose this. The directors weren't happy with our performance at Arsenal, and I can kind of understand why, because although the scoreline wasn't too bad, we didn't get thrashed. But Arsenal were clearly the superior team and should have won by more. We're trying to hold on for a replay here, it seems. Nothing much happening at all. This is poor. What are these guys doing? Have I got 11 players on the pitch? Come on, Jamie. Yeah, he's got Robbie Fowler in his pocket. That Tuttle guy. But we are doing a little bit better now that we've made those changes. Maybe Jamie Carragher has made a difference. Yeah, Robbie Fowler, you know, he was in form, then he got injured, and he needs to regain his form. Well, we're lucky to be 0-0. I thought we were showing some signs of life, but come on. Oh. Yeah, their defenders are playing darn well. League Cup fourth round, I've just noticed. Because I guess we start with third round. I can't remember who I beat in the previous round. It was nothing to write home about. Come on, Danny. Could have been it. For someone with a creativity of 17, Nick Barmby doesn't actually do that much in the cam role. Daniel Soland. Is that the winner? Commentators think so. Perhaps he has a future at the club, this lad. Have Chesterfield run out of steam here? I'd be interested to see what Carragher got for rating, because he does seem to have done well in the defensive midfield position. Well, we eked through there. But anyway, that will have to do it for episode 15. And yeah, things went as expected, really. Lost at Arsenal. We just about managed to beat Chesterfield away. So not very inspiring. Doesn't fill us with lots of hope for the future. But we'll carry on nonetheless and see what happens. So leave a like, comment. Please subscribe, that would be nice if you're into Championship Manager. See you in the next video. Bye.